What's up you guys, hope you're all doing good and welcome to our Dream Dot channel once again. For those who are visiting our channel for the first time, let me quickly introduce myself. I'm Jagdish, a software developer with around 10 years of experience. So far in our channel, we have been trying to cover some of the basics of Java programming. So if you're interested in learning Java from the basics, don't forget to go and check out our channel. And we also have a playlist which combines all the videos like the Java for Beginners, where you can go and learn Java from the fundamentals. In our recent past videos, we spoke about the data types in Java and what are the various types of variables available in Java. If you missed it, don't forget to check it out. Today in this video, we're going to talk about what are operators in Java and what are the various kinds of operators available in Java. So this is going to be a theoretical session. Like, it's not going to be a demo or a practical purpose for some reason. Like, in our next video, we'll try to explain each and every operator practically. And in this video, let's talk extensively about what are the various types of operators available in Java and what are operators in general. Without our knowledge, like, most of us tend to use these operators. So operators are nothing but they are used for performing a specific operation. That is what is called as an operator. And the operation on which it is performed on, that particular variable is what is called as an operand. So there are various types of operators available in Java. So these are some of the basic categories that we have categorized. Like, first one is arithmetic operators. Next is assignment. Then we have the increment and the decrement operators. Then we have the logical operators. Then comes the comparison operators. Then the bitwise and the ternary operator. Let's see what all the operators gets categorized under each of these types. When taking arithmetic operators into consideration, all the basic mathematical operations will be categorized under the arithmetical operators. For example, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and the modulo operation. All these operations will be covered under the arithmetic operators. So addition would be done using a plus sign, subtraction using a minus sign, multiplication using an asterisk, division using a forward slash, and modulo using the percentile operator. And next we talk about the assignment operators. Assignment operators in general are used for assigning a value to a variable, like equal to. Like, some of the assignment operators which are available in Java or which can be categorized under the word assignment is equals is an assignment operator. Like, you can assign a value to a variable using the equals. And you have plus equals, minus equals, asterisk equals, slash equals, and percentile equals. The meaning for plus equals would be like, plus equals will be equal to that variable plus some particular value. So we will talk about all these things extensively when we are talking specifically about the assignment operators. Maybe in this video, let's keep it very simple. Let's only talk about the type and what all the operators which are available. Because in our further videos, we're going to talk extensively about each and every operator in detail. And then the third category of operators is what is called as an increment or a decrement operators. Like, in the for loop, you would have noticed like i++, j++, something of such kind, which is used for auto incrementing or decrementing a particular variable. So those operators are called as the increment or the decrement operators. And plus and minus are the two types of increment and the decrement operators that we have in Java. And then comes the logical operations. Logical operations are used for performing the operations using the Boolean values. We have three types of logical operators which are available. Like, we have the OR operation, we have the AND operation, and we have the NOT operation. So OR operation, it will return true value if either of the value is true. And AND operator will return true only if both the values are true. If any one of the value is false, the result will be false. And NOT operator is just going to inverse your value. Like, if the value is true, it will convert it to false. If it is false, it will convert it into true. So basically, it is an inverse operator. And the next type is called as, after the logical operator, we have the relational operators. So relational operators is used for establishing a relationship between the between two variables or the two values, in what way they can be connected to each other. Like, the basic connection is going to be whether they are going to be equal or they're going to be greater, lesser, greater than equal, or less than equal and not equal to. So the operators, they are not used to for these operations. For truth's sake, whether the two values are equal or not, we can make use of equal to equal to. So that is a basic difference between a single equal to and two equal to signs. If it is a single equal to, we are trying to assign a value to a variable. But if it is two equal to sign together, then it means we're trying to compare those two values, because most of them tend to confuse between a single equal to and a double equal to sign. And greater than or equal to, this is the operator for it, less than or equal to, not equal to, greater than or lesser than. And then comes the bitwise operators, I guess. Yes, so bitwise operators are used for performing bit operations. We'll talk about it extensively when you talk about bitwise operators in specific. So the operators that are specific to bitwise operations are and a single pipe symbol for performing the OR operation, a caret symbol for performing the exclusive OR operation, and a tilde sign for performing the complement operations, a left shift, a right shift, and a zero fill right shift. So all these operations will be performed on bit basis, like bit basis in the sense when you're trying to convert your value in binary values, and then you, if you want to perform some operation, then you can make use of this bitwise operators. And there is a difference between a single ampersand and two ampersand. If it is a two ampersand, then it is a logical AND operation, and if it is a single AND, then it is called as a bitwise AND operation. And similarly, if it is a single pipe symbol, it becomes a bitwise OR operator. But if it is a two pipe symbols together, then it is a logical OR operation. Okay, so you don't have to confuse between a bitwise operation and a logical operation, as operators are almost similar, just the repetition alone varies. And finally, the most important operator is called as a conditional or the ternary operator. So here we have two operators together for performing. We have a question mark sign and we have a colon. So these two or together is what is called as a conditional or a ternary operator. So all the above operators that we have seen, they call it as a unary or a binary operator. In other words, we can also differentiate the operators into three different categories called as a unary, a binary, and a ternary operator. A unary operator is something that is going to act on only one operand. For instance, when you take the increment or the decrement, plus plus and minus minus, this will act only on one operand. Like, it will act only on one variable name, like num plus plus, num minus minus. This is what is called as a unary operator, an operator which acts upon one operand. So it's called as a unary operator. And if you take operators like arithmetic operations, like addition, subtraction, it will act on two operands. For example, num1 plus num2. So a single operator plus will act upon two operands. So we call these kind of operators called the binary operators. And these conditional operator are called as a ternary operator because it acts upon three operands. For example, we have a condition and we have a value and we have another value. So if this condition is satisfied, it assigns a value, value 1, to the left hand side. Else, it will assign the value, value 2, to the left hand side. For example, in this example, if you take, so boolean val equals, if num1 equal to 100, val will become true. If num1 is not 100, then it takes value false. So here the operator question mark and colon acts upon three operands. It acts upon this particular value, it acts upon this one, and it acts upon this one. So we call this as the ternary operators. Basic types are like arithmetic, logical, and all those things. But as a whole, if you want to club all these operators and if you want to categorize them, you can categorize into three broad categories called as unary, binary, and the ternary operators. So to reiterate what we have seen in this video, we have seen about some of the basic operators available in Java, arithmetic operators, like all the mathematical operations, assignment operators, where we are going to assign the values, auto increment and decrement, plus plus, minus minus, logical operations for performing AND or all kinds of operations, NOT, and comparison operators, whether you're going to compare they are equal or greater than or lesser than, bitwise operators for performing the bit related operations by converting them into binary values, and ternary operator always called as a conditional operator. And other three broad categories are unary, binary, and the ternary operators. Unary operators are those which are going to happen on a single operand, like the increment and the decrement operators, where they're going to act only on a single operand, like value plus plus, value minus minus. For instance, I think I missed it somewhere. Let's quickly take it. These are called as the unary operators, as they are going to act on only one operand. And the second category are called as a binary operators, where they act on two operands, like the logical operators or arithmetic operators. And last, we have the ternary operators, where we are going to act upon three operands, like the conditional operator, the conditional operator thing is question mark and the colon. So that's it in this video. Hope you found this video informative. And if you found this video helpful, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. And in the further videos, we will talk extensively about each of the single operators by making use of a demo. Thank you.